So when you're thinking about what a conservator, what their responsibility is, one is to repair damage that has occurred to an artwork and any sort of problems with its aging, natural aging. But the other component that conservators are really concerned with is preventing that damage from happening in the first place. If you think about the types of things that can cause harm to an artwork, handling is really by far one of the main contributing factors. Artists are working with materials in very unconventional ways. For example, with the Noguchi, we have an artwork that has light bulbs in it that need to be changed out. In order to do that, it's really important that the artwork is turned upside down so that you can access the verso, the back of the piece. It's difficult to make sure that you're supporting it evenly across its surface. The benefit of having a cavity pack for this artwork, especially one that's 3D scanned, is it is mapping exactly the surface, is going to provide even distribution of weight and support underneath the piece. So it's important that we had something that really matched the contour of the surface. 3D scanning was this perfect opportunity to do that. The 7-Up Oldenburg piece is a plaster-infused fabric over a chicken wire frame, and then the surface is painted. These are very, very brittle pieces, and to travel them in a safe manner is something that takes a lot of creative thought. We did find that there has been precedence for 3D scanning the surface and then creating a tray to then support the artwork without having any sort of unevenly distributed pressure over the surface, which is really key on this piece. Knowing that 3D scanning had been successfully used in the past, it made perfect sense for us to utilize that technology in transporting this artwork as well. Obviously, before 3D scanning, there was the ability to pack artwork safely. This just makes it that much easier. Much of my day-to-day work has to do with documenting artworks, examining them in preparation for loan, and examining them to better understand their particular hidden vulnerabilities. We have an artwork by Bruce Nauman called Hand to Mouth, and it's made of a wax material, and as you can imagine, is vulnerable to being misshapen. So we wanted to make sure that if this piece ever traveled, that we could monitor any change that changes in humidity or temperature might have in terms of its dimension. So it was scanned back in 2009, prior to going out on loan. Now when it comes back, we're able to determine, was that period of display, did that cause any major difference in the piece? And we were happy to see that between the two scans, there was just minimal difference between those. I'm looking at 3D scanning as being something that takes away hours of work trying to come up with some really creative solution. Whenever there's something that provides that for the museum staff, it just means that my focus and the museum's resources can then go towards making the show even grander than it is.